Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Someone there.
Made of.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
God be with you.
Do you know Timmy? He's a big man and,
a complete numbskull? Aye, he works here. Or he used to, I'm not sure. He vanished a few days ago. Far as I know, no one's seen him since. But try asking his sister, Mirka. She works here too.
Good luck to you.
Looking for a colossus by the name of Timmy. I heard he works here.
I don't know anyone like that.
All the others know him, so how come you don't?
All right, but not here. We'll talk around the back, behind the mill.
Here I am. So, why all the secrecy?
What do you want from Timmy?
Can you tell me where to find him?
Promise me nothing will happen to him.
Why do you care so much?
He's my brother. He's not very smart, you see. And he's always getting led astray by his no-good friends. And now there's some right peculiar characters looking for him.
Who are they?
I don't know. But they look like cutthroats. And they said some strange things, but I didn't tell them anything.
That's good. But sooner or later they'll find him anyway. Tell me where he is and I'll take care of him.
He's hiding at the Colburn farm, over by Merhoyed.
The feeling you're looking for someone here. I'm looking for someone too. Maybe we could help each other.
And who are you looking for?
A great big ox by the name of Timmy.
That's interesting. I'm also looking for a big ox called Timmy.
Well, what are the chances? Could it be the same fellow, I wonder? Now, if someone were to tell me where to find Timmy, I might offer that man a job. We could use a smart fellow like that at the camp.
I hear he's hiding in Ratai.
Oh, yeah? Where in Ratai?
He's at the butcher's. They're his kin.
Well, excuse me if I take that with a grain of salt. I'll just leave Radan here to keep an eye on you. For your own protection, you know. Come with us if you've got the stomach for it. If not, come and find us in the Samapesh Tavern when it's all over. Or we'll find you. Come on, boys!
What do you want? Don't fucking annoy me.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Good afternoon.
Let's have a word about the price.
Well, we can try it.
Satisfied?
I'd almost shake on that. Almost. Aye, that would do it.
What's going on there? What are you doing here? Tired of life, are you?
Look what I've got for you. You'll love this.
You better believe it. Just you look at it all. First we had the plague, then war raging in our land, and now murder and mayhem. I heard from Ujit's folk there was a stink of...
I heard that too.
But God-fearing Christians like us have nothing to fear.
No, I suppose not.
Yeah.
You've got a little time to spare.
What is it?
I'd like to challenge you to a duel, sir. A little amicable combat.
Why would I want to fight you?
An honorem, friend. For honor. For the thrill of combat.
Sorry, but I won't risk getting crippled on account of some tavern yarn.
I understand. Then I was mistaken about you. My apologies for troubling you.
Yeah.
Hey, Timmy. How are you today?
I'm all right. Have we met?
We have now.
Huh? Oh, shit. What do you want? It wasn't me. Shit.
I saw what you did at Neuhof.
What are you talking about? You weren't there. I wasn't there.
Don't waste your breath. You were there with Limpy Lubosch and Riki. I heard all about it.
What do you want from me?
Your mate Hinnek told me about a whole camp full of those horse huns. And I want to find it. I need to find it.
Yeah, but why should I trust you, though? I'm not stupid. You might be one of them. Pretending to not be one of them. Trying to catch me out. I won't tell you nothing.
Why would I be trying to catch you out? For Christ's sake, man, they crucified Limpy Lubosch in Ujits. What the hell are you trying to pull here?
Shit. What will I do? Shit. I don't know where their camp is.
That's a load of horse shit. Hinnek told me you were there, and that Pius warned you to keep your mouth shut. You must know something.
Well, once I was there with them, yeah. Only, I was pretty drunk, so I'm not too sure.
Try to remember.
It was in the woods. In some kind of woods. You know, with trees and stuff. There were some wrecked houses there and all. In the woods. A church! There was a church there. Kind of a broken one, though.
Oh, great. Thanks a lot. Now it's all clear to me. Do you remember which way you went?
It was straight north from Talmberg. When you go uphill from the castle, there's a path there round some barns, I think. It leads to the woodcutter's camp. If you go further on past the woodcutters, you come across this abandoned house. Can't miss it. Looks like a house, only abandoned. Go to the left there and carry on till you come to this clearing with a big beech tree. Or was it an oak? You go left there again. There's this narrow path and you go straight along there. Sometimes it splits up. You just keep to the left until you come to a crossroads by this big flat rock. You keep straight on there. After a while, you'll see a bridge. And it's right there. Easy as you please.
Better than nothing, I suppose.
But you won't tell nobody about Neuhoff, right? You promised. Oh, no, bugger. I meant to make you promise, but I forgot.
No, don't worry. But in future, find some other way to make money. Like honest work?
Thanks. I'll try. On account of my sister, at least.
That girl at the windmill?
Hi, Mirka. Did you talk to her? What did she say?
She told me you're as thick as a fence post and always getting dragged into some mischief.
Did she? Yeah, she's probably right.
God bless you. What troubles you?
About that encampment, sir.
What is it, lad?
I found out about the camp from another of the bandits who deserted. It's called Timmy. Big fellow, but more brawn than brain. The camp is an abandoned village in the woods to the west of Townburg.
Good work, lad. Have you been to check it out? Do you know how many of them there are?
I don't know much, apart from where it is.
We really need to find out more. Could you go back there and try to discover anything that could help us in the assault? The more we know, the better. And if you could carry out some sabotage while you're in there, it would be invaluable. But don't take any unnecessary risks. I don't want to lose you.
Certainly, sir. That is, I'll do what I can.
That's what I like to hear. You'll be our eyes and ears, lad. Our success will depend on what you find out. Go, and get back here as soon as you can. Meanwhile, I'll muster my men.
I'll find out what I can and be right back.
Take care.
I have some news about the investigation, sir.
Good. Tell me.
The trail leads to Ujits. I found out one of the bandits is from there, a fellow they call Limpy Lubosh.
I see. What else?
I went to Ujit, where they told me I could find Lubosh, only someone had murdered him. It seems they're trying to cover their tracks and get rid of witnesses.
Indeed. The whole affair's becoming ever more suspicious. Have you any further clues?
I found out about another one of them, a crony of Limpy Lubosh's. They call him Riki, and he comes from Ledechko.
You're doing a good job. But you need to be careful. Have you found this Riki fellow?
I'm afraid my news isn't good, sir.
I might have expected as much. Tell me the worst.
This Riki fellow was hiding out in the woods, and his former accomplices really did want to kill him because he, Limpy Lubosch and others deserted them in Neuhof. It seems they wanted no part in the killing. Anyway, Riki told me they were hired by a bandit they call Runt. He's the one who stole your sword. Those murdering whore sons weren't after loot. They just wanted to do damage. And the worst thing is, they have an encampment in the area, and they're getting ready to make more trouble.
Sacra. Anything else?
That's all I've found out so far, sir.
All right. Come back and report to me as soon as you learn anything new.
God be with you.
God be with you. Take care now.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Ha ha!
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
I'll be with you.
Have you got a bed for the night?
Aye, there's room here. For how long?
Just the one night.
No problem. But you pay in advance.
That's quite a lot. Can we discuss the price? Agree?
Well, a little more, and we'll call it a deal. You'll like it here. Like sleeping on a cloud it is.
Where do I go to sleep?
On the upper floor of the inn. There are steps up to it outside. The middle room is yours.
May the Lord watch out.
a word from me.
Yeah. Yeah! Yeah!
Itt az ellenség! Ott mi? Látjátok? Ott a szegény láda!
Yeah.
Is something the matter? What's it to be?
Wait a moment. You're him, right? The boy from Scarlet's. You're the young fellow who came here from Scarlet's, half dead, aren't you?
Why do you ask?
Well, if it is you, the lady of the castle's looking for you.
Ah, I'll go and see her then. Thank you.
Very well. Don't make her wait. Take care now.
God be with you. Do you need anything? Goodbye. May the Lord watch over you.
Good day to you. What do you need?
Have you got any work that needs doing?
Not much. Unless you're not averse to a bit of risk.
How do you mean?
As you can see, I tan hides. I can only buy them from the master huntsman, and he never gives me enough. I'd hunt them down myself, only he keeps a close watch on me. But you now...
Well, I don't think the master huntsman would be any happier about me hunting on his preserve.
He wouldn't, if he caught you at it. Look here, I'll pay a good price for whatever you bring me. And sometimes I have to fill an order and I need something in particular, in which case I would pay you extra. And if you help me out a few times, I might be able to teach you something useful.
Take care now.
Couldn't you use some hides?
I need the hide of a sturdy roe buck. There's a wealthy merchant after one to hang on his wall. As if anyone would believe he bagged it himself.
May the Lord watch over you.
God be with you.
What can I do for you? May the Lord watch over.
Christ above, blood! Are you all right?
I'd like to make use of the bathhouse's services.
And what is it you'd like?
I'll certainly need a physician to treat my wounds. Then a hot bath and laundering my clothes.
But of course. Money first, though.
I'm not giving you that much.
And how much are you willing to pay?
Since it's you.
Well, a little more and we'll call it a deal. You won't regret spending the money. I guarantee it.
May the Lord watch over you.
Hey! God be with you.
May the Lord watch over you. Thank you.
Look out. What was that?
Who's there? Answer me.
Good day to you. What do you need?
I have some trophies.
Show me. So many. My lad, you're like the smiting right hand of God.
The Lord save you. What do you need?
I heard you wanted to talk to me, my lady.
It's true. I need something from you.
How can I help?
My cousin, young Sophie, is going to be wed. It will be an entry into a new life, and I want everything to be perfect for her. I'm looking for a few things to give her as a gift, and you're going to find them for me.
My lady, why me?
Normally I'd let the Chamberlain take care of it, but he doesn't have any taste. I can't trust him with this. And I've been told no task is too challenging for you. Is that not true?
It will be my honor, my lady.
I need you to pick up an ornamental crown from Sassau for Sophie, wine from a merchant in Rattai, and a roan from the stable in Ujits.
Who am I supposed to pick up the wine from?
From Conrad Hagen in Rattai. He's the only person in the whole region who can supply a genuinely good wine. And believe me, I know what I'm talking about. Here you go. That should be enough.
And the ornamental crown?
I had the engravers in Sassau make it, but now they've written to say it will take a while longer. That just won't do. The wedding is almost upon us, and I need it. Go and see Master Jeronim Sleski and pick it up.
You said a roan from Ujits?
Precisely. It's a beautiful animal. Wait till you see it. Dietrich said he'd ride it here himself, but I can already imagine how he'll end up killing himself on that horse. But you, so young and vigorous.
Wine, a roan, and a crown. I can handle that.
Thank you, Henry. I just wish there were others here I could trust so well.
God bless.
I'd like to improve my swordsmanship.
Certainly.
I'd like to hone my skills.
First, you have to have some skills to hone.
I'm interested in more advanced techniques.
All right, but it'll cost you.
Isn't that quite a lot? Agree?
Come now, just a little more and we have a deal. Agreed. Now, listen up.
Look out! Thank you.
I wonder what Teresa's doing now. I could stop by and see her again. I enjoyed it last time.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Wait here for me. Stay.
Moat. It would take a while to get across, and there's nowhere to shelter from arrows. Good ground for a big fight, but not much cover.
Thank you. puzzled.
A bridge. That'll make it easier to cross the earthworks. There's open ground on both sides of it, but it's the fastest route for an attack. A stockade. A handful of men could hold it for quite a while.
nozzle! What's going on?
We could launch a sneak attack from here.
Hey! What the fuck are you looking at? Get lost! Before I count to three, or you're dead meat. Get lost before I kick your ass.
Three, four, four.
They can see a long way from that steeple. And those archers up there, definitely going to be a problem. Look at that. Those heathens are a lot tidier than the bandits.
Hey, te, várj csak egy kicsit. Mit akarsz, hogy ennyit bámészkodszik?
Hogy az nem kell?
Itt csinálhatod, ahol akarod. Úgyis térdig járunk itt a szarban.
The fewer arrows you have, the better for us.
Ki vagy?
Látod őket? Tegnap még az anyjuk szoknyája alá bújtak.
Well, you won't be shooting these arrows.
Mi csak? Mi bújt itt elő?
A szentség itt! Látjátok! Ellenség! Istenem, vigyázzon!
Itt épp egy malacka tévedt a
disztóra. Felfalnám a gyümmalmat.
Ezért megdög lesz!
Yeah. Yeah.
Good health to you.
Can we trade?
If you've got the coin. Good luck to you.
Can we trade?
If you've got the coin. Farewell.
I'd like to discuss the price.
All right, so.
Here, with a little something on top for a good measure.
Well now, thank you very much.
Heal. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
My respects to you. God be with you.
Greetings. What do you need?
I'm back from scouting, sir.
Excellent. What have you found out?
There aren't just bandits in the camp. There are Cumans too, quite a few of them.
Cumans, you say? Where the hell did they come from? Could Sigismund have left them there after he raised Scalitz? This is looking more and more serious.
There's an overgrown, ruined village in the woods where they're dug in.
That sounds like Pribyslavitz. It used to belong to Sir Divish before Havel Medic attacked and torched it, and then imprisoned Divish. It's been left abandoned ever since. I was hoping they wouldn't be so organized. Earthworks and fortifications. That's quite a different matter from routing some rabble out of the woods.
I tried to count them.
And how many of them are there? Bear in mind I'm relying on what you say. We'll have to call for reinforcements, and that's no simple matter. Every man that comes with us will be lacking somewhere else. And I don't want bandits pillaging some other town because there's no one left to mount a defense.
There's a lot of them. I couldn't even count them all.
Christ. We'll have to gather armed forces from the whole region to defeat them. Even if it means leaving towns and villages unprotected. Every able-bodied man will have to come with us.
It's mostly bandits in the camp. They're not villagers with pitchforks, but not regular soldiers either.
No more than I expected. I have no fear of them, but underestimating the enemy can be fatal.
I took a look at their arms and armor. They're not a proper army, but they're equipped quite well.
What about archers?
There's a few of them, and they're positioned well. If we charge them head-on, they'll probably do us a lot of damage.
I don't like the sound of that. It complicates the situation. Dealing with them before the battle would be the best option.
They're up to something in the middle of the camp. It looked like they were making several long ladders.
Ladders? That sounds like they're planning a siege. I like this less and less. On the other hand, we can use that to our advantage. If we can capture those ladders, we can use them to scale their own fortifications.
That's about all I saw, sir. I didn't notice anything else.
That's all right. Did you manage any sabotage while you were there, as I asked you?
I managed to destroy some of their arrow supplies, so they'll have less ammunition.
Well done. That's just what we need.
That's all, sir.
Don't worry, Henry. You've proven yourself an excellent spy. I need you to go to Sir Divish in Tarnberg and tell him to send Captain Robard and his men to our aid. There's not enough of us here in the camp.
You can rely on me, sir. What should I tell him?
Tell Sir Robard to bring all his men, leaving only a minimum guard at the castle. And to send a message to Sir Hanush to send his men too. I'll leave our camp almost empty as well. We'll need every man we can muster.
All right, I'll get going.
And be quick. We've no time to spare. God be with you. See you later.
Yeah.
I'd love to get something to eat. I'm starting to get hungry.
Greetings. What business have you?
God save, my lord. I hope things are peaceful in your fiefdom.
Peace? Peace is rare in these times. But right now I'm more troubled by politics than warfare.
What's wrong?
The monastery stalled the purchase of stone and everything connected to the building project. And now I find out. It's because of the quality of the stone blocks, or so they say. I don't believe a word of it. It looks like profiteering to me.
What do they say is wrong with the stone?
Supposedly, there was an accident when one of the stone blocks broke loose, fell, and killed someone. But the quarrymaster swears by all the saints it isn't possible. He says he sends only the best stone, and I believe him. He's reliable and an experienced quarryman.
Profiteering? What's the monastery trying to accomplish?
To lower the price. What else? We've already given them a fair price, and they still delay with payment. Or worse.
Worse? You mean they'll stop paying completely?
You could put it that way. They're looking for an excuse to back out of the contract and find another quarry where they'll be able to secure a more favorable deal.
And is anyone dealing with the problem?
Well, my chamberlain is in charge of it, as always. But all he's done is send them a letter. He says putting more pressure on the monastery could provoke them. Those are his words.
So there's nothing else that can be done?
I don't know. I've been thinking about taking a more direct approach. But I expect the chamberlain won't even hear of it. He'll just keep on sending them polite letters and hoping that does the trick.
I could help with this.
Do you think this is a job for you? You aren't even in my service.
I do serve Sir Radzig. He knows he can rely on me when he needs me, and I've never let him down.
This is true. So do you want to go to Sassau and ask about the stone?
Yes, I'll do it.
Good. I'd like you to ask about the stone and keep your ears open. See if they aren't talking about another quarry.
I'll do my best. Hopefully they'll talk to me.
They will. You ride in my name, so don't forget to remind them of it. God be be with you.
Sir Radzig sent me with an important message. He asked for reinforcements.
He needs more men? What's going on?
The bandits and Cumans have set up camp in Pribyslavitz. They're preparing for something. Sir Radzig wants to mount an assault on them, but he doesn't have enough men.
Hang on. Easy now. From the beginning, what happened?
I managed to track down the camp of the bandits who raided Neuhof. But it's not just a gang of brigands. More like a small army in a fortified encampment. I don't know what they're up to, but I'm sure they're getting ready for something. And Sir Radzig wants to destroy them before they get a chance.
So it's worse than I thought. But Sir Radzig is right. We should do something about them before it's too late. I'll send my soldiers.
Sir Radzig said to take all your men and leave only a minimum guard at the castle.
What? We can't leave Talmberg unguarded.
We've no choice, sir. The bandits have an awful lot of men. Sir Radzig is leaving his camp almost empty as well. He even said you should send word to Sahanish to send his men too. We need every man we can muster.
All right then. Sir Radzig knows what he's doing. I'll muster the men and send them with Captain Robard in command. Would you lead my men there right now?
Yes, sir.
May God be with you in battle. Farewell.
Radzig.
I'm glad to see you, Captain Robard. I hope Henry's explained everything to you.
He did. But I find it hard to believe. Who could possibly put together such a significant military force, and right under our noses?
We'll just have to find out, but I don't think we will until after a battle. If we don't deal with them now, who knows what they'll be capable of in a week or two.
I agree entirely, my lord. What's the plan?
Right, lad. We're almost at the place you described. Now we'll have to advance cautiously. I need you to tell me how it looks around the camp, so I can decide which side to lead the attack from.
Sir, that's a big responsibility. I don't think I should...
I asked you a question, boy. You've been there and seen everything, so speak up.
There are three ways to get in. Directly along the straight path to the camp, the long way round through the woods and over an old weir, or by a narrow bridge over a deep ditch.
Let's start with the direct route. That sounds like the easiest approach. How does it look there?
That path leads round their battlements. It's fortified and patrolled. Chances are they'd shower us with arrows on the way.
It's a good thing you're here, Henry. Have to try another way, then. What about the approach through the woods and the weir? I don't like the idea of marching such a long way over rough ground, but if it's the better option...
It's a long way through the woods, and there are patrols there as well. They'll call the alarm before we reach the camp.
I thought so. What about the last approach, over the bridge? It's a bit narrow for my liking.
It's narrow, all right. But once we get over, we can quickly occupy the best ground for a battle. We only have to take down a few archers.
The battleground sounds inviting, but that bridge and the archers... It's not an easy decision. Each option has its pros and cons.
I try to answer to the best of my ability, sir.
And you'll be suitably rewarded for your efforts. From what you say, the route over the bridge is the best option. If we're fast, we'll have the advantage. With the help of God, we'll win this day. We'll approach from the south and storm them over the bridge. Form up. Forward march. Go!
Two places at once. Arrows, shields overhead.
Find your grounding dogs! Drive them back!
My fucking sword.
What the fuck are you on about? What's... Hang on. You're the... Fuck me. I thought we left you to the crows. Tough little fucker, eh?
What did you do with my sword?
Judging by our last encounter, I'd say you made a big mistake.
Where's my fucking sword?
But then again, maybe you've had some practice. I hope so. Because last time was too easy.
Take that!
You didn't expect that, eh?
Stop pitching!
Yeah.
Jesus Christ! Oh dear, did that hurt? Looking for more? Oh! Fuck this.
My sword. What have you done with it? Talk, you bastard!
I'll see you.
Tell me, do you hear me? Tell me what you've done with it!
I'd say you're flogging a dead horse there.
Took him down. On your own. Well done. Nice work. You surprised me. He was a mountain of a man.
He was the one who attacked Neuhoff. And stole your sword, sir.
The thought did cross my mind. What did he tell you? If we'd taken him alive, the executioner might have gotten more out of him. Oh well, these things happen in the heat of battle. Anyway, we found a trunk full of coin down below. Someone was paying this gang very well. There were some of Sigismund's barbarians among them. I don't think we've seen the last of this. Whoever engineered it was highly placed. They won't give up after one defeat. This louse was just a pawn.
I'm afraid you're right, sir. Well, lad, you live to fight another day, eh? That's the fear leaving you, lad. Let it go. Now, put it all behind you. A decent Christian shouldn't dwell on such horrors.
I beg to differ, sir. I never want to forget this. The time has come for those whore sons to pay for what they did to us.
You're right, my boy. But first, we all need some rest. We'll meet later in the upper castle in Ratte and then decide what to do next. But come what may, you did a good job today.
I will make you pay for this. It's time for the next part of our plan. Give the word.
Yes, sir.